Hi, I'm David Kraft with the Kansas Grazing Land Coalition, and today we're going to talk about different elements of a prescribed burn and prescribed burn activities. Today we're going to talk about at least three different ignition techniques and also a type of burn that is commonly used when we apply prescribed burning in the state of Kansas. The first one would be a backfire, and a backfire typically is on the downwind side of a prescribed or targeted burn area where we have safe conditions, whether that be a plow line or something down to a bare mineral soil or a backfire line which we can adequately protect fire from escape. We'll be lighting the fire along with the wind blowing into our face so that the fire is creeping back against the wind away from that protected area. Once that backfire is established, or that backfire line is established, and we have a defendable area, then we can proceed with additional burning techniques or ignition techniques. But they're wanting to make sure that they have a controlled area on the downwind side of the fire or the burn unit. They'll use water as well to secure that backfire to make it sure that it doesn't actually leave the area that is targeted for the burn. With the wind blowing out of the north-northeast today, you can see how the flames are burning backwards. The heat of this fire is actually kind of curling underneath itself and backing into the fuel. Backfires typically are a fairly slow method of actually consuming fuel and are commonly used to protect the downwind side of an area that is being burned, or at least from that fire escaping the actual designed area that be burned. So now, to widen out that backfire, they will join with the burn coming from the west side of it, and they're going to actually strip across the fuel load and actually widen out the backfire. Again, our goal would be to make sure that we have at least 10 times the height of the fuel as a backfire or a fire break. After a backfire is used and the downwind portion of the prescribed burn area is safely protected, the next ignition technique that a lot of times will be used is a flank fire. Individuals that are carrying fire then would be walking directly into the wind, where we're trying to establish a perimeter or at least a boundary on the left and right side of the fire where the primary ignition will take place. So we're often then securing an area that will then protect the area or the area from the fire to escape. So the flank fire typically, again, is lit directly into the wind and then established where it can burn sideways into the actual burn area until we have a protected area established. Following a flank fire, then a lot of times after we've got the downwind side protected and the two areas on the side, the flanks of the fire or the prescription area protected, then we would light a head fire, where the individuals then would carry the fire across the upper portion of the fire with the wind directly to their back, pushing the fire away from them. Head fire actually burns very quickly and then encloses the area to actually be burned. So the prescription area then becomes all encased within fire on each boundary of it, the downwind side, the two sides, and then the headwind or the upper portion of the fire, bringing all the fires together and closing them out. So no backfiring, no flank fire, just a pretty common type of head fire ignition with this one. We've got a protected area downwind from that. Again, we're seeing flame lengths that probably exceed 3 to 4 feet over the height of the fuel. Because we have a little bit of a northeast breeze, the majority of the fire is kind of pushing away from the eastern boundary. Many times this will be described as a ring fire, where actually the individuals that are conducting the fire would connect the fire, not only from the back or from the backfire portion, but also the flank fires, and then connecting around the top to where the head fire then moves the fire directly into the portion, the middle portion of the prescription area. This is a very safe way to conduct a fire or a prescription fire to where it becomes quickly established and quickly completed after all sides of the fire are protected downwind to the sides and then the head fire lit. So what they're demonstrating here is a ring fire technique, which they will start on the downwind side and two igniters will encircle the area that's going to be burned, and they'll come back together on the back side or the upwind side of the burn unit and close it in. So as Courtney gets to this northwest corner of the property, they're going to make sure that the other igniter on the east end can see where they're at. Now they're going to drag their fire with the direction of the wind coming over the top of them. They're going to drag their fire along the northern border of the property. See, as the two fire fronts come together, they start to draw towards each other with the wind that's being sucked into the fire. They're going to close this out pretty quickly because the western boundary is starting to close in. Now they've got it completely enclosed. This is a ring fire ignition. It can be very quick, can be pretty intense, may not necessarily be too wildlife friendly, but is effective.